Director Spike Lee is back with his latest HBO documentary on the city of New Orleans. If God is willing and the creek don't rise, a follow-up to Lee's 2006 film When the Levees Broke, marks Hurricane Katrina's fifth anniversary and talks about the city's ongoing struggle to rebuild after the storm and the Gulf Coast's latest disaster, the BP oil spill. Lee sat down with the Griot to discuss his new film and the challenges New Orleans still faces.
How can a city withstand so much and still keep going?
The spirit of the people. Because you got the spirit, you could take almost anything. But they've had two huge hits in less than 4 years.
How long will it take for the city to get back on its feet?
It's going to be another 5-10 years. It's easy for me to say, but that's what a lot of experts say. But when you're living there, and every day you're driving around and you continue to see houses that are abandoned and look like the same way they looked 5 years ago, is a constant reminder, and it's a visual reminder, it's in your face, like things aren't progressing fast enough.
Because of the demographic changes and because mostly, you know, low-income African-American residents and other residents aren't able to get back in their homes or get jobs again, do you see New Orleans' kind of cultural identity? Do you see that changing?
You don't have the people there, you're losing the culture. People make up the culture, and the people make up the culture aren't there, then that's a loss. 37% of the African American community has still not returned. You have African Americans who had relocated to Atlanta, San Antonio, Houston, found better paying jobs, better housing, a higher standard of living, which includes better education for their kids, and they're like, bet, I'm cool. Then you have the other group who's like, I gotta get home. But they can't go home because there are very few jobs. The rents have quadrupled. You got these African Americans who want to come back. They're in exile, really.
President Obama can say or do one thing, bring the wrath on BP or just address the Gulf Coast in general when we're talking about Katrina's effect on New Orleans. What can he say? What can he do?
Well, I think that he's going to have a lot of opportunities to do something because this stuff still has to be played out in court. And even though he got $20 billion from BP already, only one-third of the claims have been paid so far. And who knows how much cost it's going to be to clean up. The Exxon Valdez oil spill was 20 years ago. They are still cleaning that up today. And what happened in the Gulf is 20 times what happened in Alaska. Scientists are saying like 75% of the oil is gone, disappeared, evaporated.
You don't buy that.
As we say in Brooklyn, nah. Not buying it.